Welcome to the geography class. The lesson that I'm going to continue today is lesson number 12, Agriculture in India, part 3, Cash Crops, with the following objectives. Through this lesson, we will learn about the cash crops like cotton, jute, oilseeds, sugarcane, tea and coffee under the following headings: importance or characteristics of each crop, their types or varieties, their geographical requirements, that is type of soil, temperature and rainfall required to grow them, their methods of cultivation, problems of each crop, area states where these crops are grown in India along with the largest producer of each crop. In the previous lecture, you have learned a very important cash crop, that is sugarcane, with the following objectives. What type of crop is sugarcane? Type of soils in which sugarcane is grown? Climatic requirements, that is temperature and rainfall needed to grow sugarcane? Its methods of cultivation, that is set method, ratooning, advantages and disadvantages of ratooning, diseases that harm the crop, uses of sugarcane, area, states where sugarcane is grown in India, sugar cultivation in North India and South India, and problems of sugar cultivation. So before proceeding with the next crop, let us recall sugarcane with the help of few terms and cross questions covered in it. Terms: number 1, bamboo; number 2, clay loam; number 3, sets; number 4, kharif season; number 5, set method; number 6, ratooning; number 7, ratoon crop. Now cross questions: name some products of sugarcane. What type of crop is sugarcane and in which cropping season is it grown? What type of soils are ideal for the growth of sugarcane? List the climatic requirements, that is temperature and rainfall, ideal for the growth of sugarcane. Explain the process of propagation of sugarcane by ratooning. State any two advantages and any two disadvantages of sugarcane. Name some insects that against which sugarcane plant needs to be protected. List some diseases that harm the sugarcane plant. Give reason why is it necessary to crush sugarcane within 24 hours of harvesting. Give reason why is it necessary to build sugarcane factories near the sugarcane fields. Why is sugarcane cut at the ground level, leaving the root intact in the soil? State the uses of sugarcane. Mention to large sugar producing states, one each in North and South India. Name the state which is the largest sugarcane producing state in India. List some conditions that favor the cultivation of sugar in North India. Why is the per hectare yield greater in South India than in North India? List some problems of sugarcane cultivation. Now, today we will begin with another important crop, that is beverages, in which we will study the first beverage, that is tea. So, we will study the pages 231 to 234 with the following objectives. What type of crop is tea? Origin of the tea crop, types or varieties of tea, soils that are ideal for the growth of tea crop. To understand the climatic requirements, that is temperature and rainfall needed to grow tea. To understand the method of cultivation for tea crop under the following headings: sowing methods, that is transplantation and clone planting, harvesting, that is plucking of the tea leaves. In its part B, we will cover rest of the points. Tea is the most important beverage crop of India, that is it is a liquid that we drink. It is mostly seen in the houses of all the Indians. Tea plantation first began in China, which is its largest producer. India is the second largest producer of tea after China. Tea was first brought to India by the Britishers in Assam in the Brahmaputra Valley. Then its production started in Darjeeling in West Bengal and then spread to the South India in the Nilgiri Hills. So today most of the tea plantations are owned by the Indians. It grows well in the tropical and subtropical climate in the hill slopes whose elevation, that is height, is between 600 to 1500 meter. Tea bushes requires warm and moist climate and frost-free climate throughout the year. Frequent and evenly distributed rainfall helps in the growth of the tender or soft tea leaves. It grows well in acidic soil rich in iron oxide. So, it is mostly grown in laterite soils. It is mainly a labor-intensive crop, that is, its processing is done by hands or manually. So, it requires large labor. It is mostly raised as a plantation crop. So, before proceeding with the reading of the topic from the book, let us go through various technical terms which will be covered in the topic. Number one, beverages. The drinks that we consume, for example, tea, coffee, juices, cold drinks, etc. Number two, transplantation. In the transplantation method, the seeds are raised in nurseries after soaking them in water for 24 hours. After 4 weeks, when the seedlings are about 20 centimeters tall, they are uprooted and are planted in the flooded or well watered fields so that they can grow again. Next term is clone planting. Clone planting is the method where cuttings are taken from good high yielding mother plant rather than the seeds. Pruning. Pruning is the removal of the central stem for the quick development of the lateral branches and not to allow the plant to grow more than 40 centimeter. Fine plucking. Fine plucking refers to the plucking of two tea leaves with a bud. Now children, open your book on page number 231. So now children, let us start reading. Beverages. The drinks that or liquid that we consume. The first beverage is tea. Tea is the most important beverage crop of India. It is considered a stimulating yet cheap drink. Tea bushes supposed to be indigenous to China, but in 1823, the British Major Robert Bruce reported the indigenous, that is native of a place, tea bushes grew wild on the hill slopes of Upper Assam. Children, I have earlier also told you that the tree was first introduced from China to India by the Britishers in the Brahmaputra Valley in Upper Assam. Following this information, tea plantation was set up in Brahmaputra Valley by the British in 1839. In the beginning, tea plantations were confined, that is limited, to Upper Assam only. But later on, they were set up in Lower Assam and Darjeeling. Thereafter, tea plantations were set up in Nilgiri Hills of South India. Tea bush is a tropical and subtropical plant. That is, it can be grown between 23.5 degree north and south latitudes and also between 40 degree north and south latitudes. Now let us read its types or varieties. There are mainly three varieties of tea available: black tea, green tea, oolong tea. So children, here we have learned the three varieties of tea. Number one is black tea, green tea, oolong tea. Green tea and oolong tea are more popular in China, Japan and Taiwan. Black tea after drying is preferred in India. That is, it is used in every home of Indians, European countries and Western countries. Soils. Now let us go through the soils which are required for the cultivation of tea. Tea bush grows well in well drained, deep, friable that is easily breakable, loams that is mixture of sand and clay, porous subsoil. Porous subsoil is the soil below the topsoil that allows the air and water to pass through it. Stagnant water, that is the water standing at a place, is injurious to its root. Hence, sandy loams are the best. Sandy loams are the loams which contains 60% of sand and only 10% of clay. However, virgin forest, that is forest having mature trees, soils rich in humus and iron content, are considered to be the best for tea plantation. A large proportion of phosphorus and potash imparts special flavor to the tea in case of Darjeeling tea. In order to increase the yield, that is output of the crop, proper amount of nitrogenous fertilizers, that is the fertilizers that are rich in nitrogen, such as ammonium sulfate, should be added to the soil. However, regular tilling of the soil to remove the weeds, that is unwanted grasses, is essential. To avoid waterlogging, that is to prevent the water from standing at a place, tea is best grown on hill slopes where water drains away easily. So here, children, a very important question is covered, that why are the tea leaves grown along the hill slopes? It grows equally well in the valley if the drainage is good. Drainage means here if the water system is good. Hence, tea can be grown on various elevations, that is height, varying from 600 meters to 1500 meters above the mean sea level. That is, it can be grown in the uplands. Climatic requirements. The first climatic requirement is temperature. The ideal temperature for growth of tea crop is 13 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius. That means the temperature below 10 degrees Celsius and above 35 degrees Celsius is injurious for its growth. Temperature below 10 degrees Celsius and above 35 degrees Celsius is harmful for the crop. Tea is a shade-loving plant and developed more vigorously, that is involving physically, when planted along with the shady trees. Frost is harmful for the crop. Children, frost is harmful for every crop. Now, coming to the next climatic requirement, that is rainfall. Tea bush requires about 150 to 250 centimeters annual rainfall, that is yearly, well distributed throughout the year. While prolonged dry spell, that is lasting for a long time, is harmful for tea, high humidity, heavy dew and morning fog favors the rapid, that is quick, development of young leaves. Now let us read the methods of cultivation of tea. Sowing. There are two methods that are mainly in use. Number one, transplantation. Children, under the transplantation method, the seeds are first sown in the nurseries, and when they attain the height of 20 centimeters, they are uprooted with the roots and then they are planted again in the well water fields. Tea gardens are set up on the cleared hill slopes where shade trees are planted in advance. We have already studied that tea plant is a shade loving plant. So that is why the shady trees are grown along with the tea plantations. Seeds are sown in the germination bed, and after 9 months, saplings, that is small young plants, are transplanted to the gardens, that is the tea gardens. The garden is already weeded, that is the unwanted grasses are already removed, so that the tea bushes grow without any hindrance or obstruction under the shade of trees. Now, next important term covered here is clone planting. Another method is to use cuttings from a good high yielding mother plant instead of seeds. So children, under the clone planting, a cutting from a good high yielding mother plant, that is the plant which has already given a good output of tea, is taken instead of sowing the seeds again in the fields. This method is called as clone planting, as the new plant also has the qualities of mother plant. So children, thus it means that the qualities of the previously grown mother plant gets the qualities or to the new plant. These small cuttings are planted in the nurseries where special care is taken. After some time, they are transported to the tea garden. Children, as I have already told you, under the transplantation method, the seeds of the tea are first grown in nurseries after soaking them for 24 hours, and then under the special care, they are allowed to grow over there, and when they grow up to 20 centimeters tall, they are uprooted and planted again in the tea gardens. So after some time, they are transplanted to the tea gardens, that is they are again grown into the tea gardens. Use of manures and fertilizers. Manures here means that the animal dung, and fertilizers that are the chemicals used to increase the fertility of soil is essential. Oil cakes, that is the residue left after the extraction of oil from the oil seeds, and green manures are generally used. Now let us go through harvesting or plucking of tea leaves. Pruning of the tea plant is very essential because of two reasons. Now children, what is this pruning? Let us read it. The removal of the central stem encourages the quick development of lateral branches, and periodical pruning does not allow the plant to grow more than 40 centimeters. Thus children, pruning is the removal of the central stem to encourage the quick development of the lateral branches, that is the small branches that will grow afterwards, and periodic pruning does not allow the plant to grow more than about 40 centimeters, because tea is a very soft plant and it pruning does not allow it to raise more than 40 centimeters in height. Because if it will be more than 40 centimeters, plucking will become difficult. This facilitates hand plucking, which is done mostly by women. Hand plucking is done by women because women have patience, and moreover, they have tender hands for plucking the soft leaves of the tree. Pruning also helps in growing new shoots bearing soft leaves in plenty. Tea leaves are already ready for plucking in about 3 to 4 years. Tea leaves plucking is very skilled job and is usually done by women. I have already told you that plucking of the tea is done by women. A skilled tea plucker can pluck about 50 kg of leaves per day. The women work their way along the tea bushes, plucking the tender, that is soft leaves, and tossing, that is putting behind in the baskets with the speed, tossing them into baskets tied at their back. The finest tea is obtained from the young shoots comprising two tea leaves and a bud, known as fine plucking. So children, what is fine plucking? Fine plucking is the plucking of two tea leaves and a bud. Bud is an unopened leaf found between first and second leaf. So children, here what is a bud? An unopened leaf found between first and second leaf. Plucking should not be done below this standard, as it results in obtaining coarse tree. Tea crop is labor intensive, that is it requires a lot of labor and requires abundant, that is enough, supply of cheap and skilled labor, that is trained labor. So children, in this part we have covered the origin of tea crop, types, varieties of tea, soils that are ideal for the growth of tea crop, climatic requirements, that is temperature and rainfall needed to grow tea, Methods of cultivation for tea crop under the following headings: sowing methods, that is transplantation and clone planting, harvesting, that is plucking of tea leaves. Thank you. Rest we will continue in the part B of the tea. Welcome back, children. In part A of the tea crop, we have studied tea under the following headings: what type of crop is tea, origin of tea crop, types or varieties of tea, soils that are ideal for the growth of tea crop, climatic requirements, that is temperature and rainfall needed to grow tea, methods of cultivation for tea crop under the headings sowing methods, that is transplantation and clone planting, and harvesting, that is plucking of tea. Now in this part, that is part B of tea crop, we will go through the five operations involved in the processing of black tea, which is a common drink in every home of our country, that is withering, rolling, fermentation, drying off, fixing, sorting, then blending and packing. Problems of tea plantation. Area, states where tea is processed in India in detail. Importance of tea in India. So children, open your book on page number 232, processing of tea. Tea processing is the method in which the leaves from the tea plant are transformed, that is changed, into the dried leaves for brewing tea, that is making tea. Tea plucking is mostly done by hands and are gathered in the tea basket tied at the back of the women pluckers. The tea leaves are then exported to the factories where the tea leaves undergo five operations to obtain the black tea. In the factories, the tea leaves are first withered by spreading them over the big racks and then oxidizing them, that is passing the air through them to remove the extra moisture so that the tea leaves are softened and are prevented from breaking. Then goes the rolling, in which the cells of tea leaves are broken down by twisting them through the roller machines so that the natural juice is exposed to the atmosphere for fermentation to set in and to give tea its characteristic flavor. Fermentation is a natural chemical process in which enzymes of the leaves are exposed to air on the cement tables for about 2 hours, so that the leaf turns from green to copper red. The fermented leaves are then placed on the conveyor belts so that hot air can be passed through them at temperature bearing 100 degrees Celsius, so that the moisture content in tea leaves is reduced and changes into normal black color. After drying, the tea leaves are sorted into various grades according to their size by passing them through a sifter. That is like you have atta channi in your home. Sifter is also a type of big channi. Finally, they are branded as peok, broken orange and dust. At the end, the tea leaves of different origin are blended, that is mixed with tea leaves of another origin to obtain the best quality tea. So these all are the steps involved in the processing of tea. But before reading the processing of the tea from the book, let us go to the various technical terms which will be covered in the topic processing. Number one, withering. Withering is the process of spreading the tea leaves over racks and then passing the air through them to remove the extra moisture. This passing of the air through the tea leaves to remove the extra moisture is termed as oxidation. Next is rolling. Rolling is the process of twisting and breaking the withered leaves, distorting or rupturing, that is burst open the internal cells and exposing the natural juice for fermentation. Now next is fermentation. Fermentation is a natural chemical process in which enzymes in the tea leaves are exposed to oxygen for about 2 hours in special trays or cement tables so that the green color of the tea leaves changes to copper red. Next is drying or fixing. The fermented leaves are led to the conveyor belt and hot air is passed at temperatures nearing 100 degrees Celsius so that the moisture content in tea leaves is reduced and changes into normal black color. Next is sorting. After drying or fixing, the tea leaves are sorted out into various grades according to their size by passing it through sieve or sifter, that is ate channi. But children, that ate channi is quite big in size. Now last, blending. Blending is the mixing of two or more different origin tea leaves to take the best quality tea with a well-balanced flavor. Now, coming back to your book, processing of tea. Processing of black tea involves 5 operations, that is, number 1, withering. The tea leaves when green contains a lot of moisture, that is, when the tree leaves are plucked from the tea gardens, they have a lot of moisture. To remove this moisture, the leaves are spread over rags and air is passed through them, which is called as oxidation. After they become soft, they are sent for rolling. So it means that the withering of the tea leaves are done so that the tree leaves become soft and they should not break up easily while rolling. The next step involved in the processing of the tea is rolling. Rolling gives the twist to the leaves, breaks the leaf cells, and the natural juice is exposed to the atmosphere for fermentation to set in. This gives the characteristic flavor to tea. So children, under the rolling, the internal cells of the tea leaves burst open and are exposed the natural juice for fermentation. Fermentation. After rolling, the tea leaves are spread out in special trays or cement tables for fermentation, which is a natural chemical process in which enzymes in the tea leaves are exposed to oxygen for about 2 hours. During this process, the tannin in tea is partly oxidized and the tea leaves changes its color from green to copper red. Next is drying or fixing. After fermentation, the tree leaves are put on conveyor belt and are passed through an oven at a very high temperature, generally 100 degrees Celsius, so that the moisture content in the tea leaves is reduced and changes its normal color into black color. This needs proper supervision as excessive temperature, that is very high temperature, will scorch, that is burn or damage the leaves, while low temperature will result in improper drying. After this process, the tree leaves get their normal black color and are ready for sorting. Now next is sorting. After drying, the leaves are sorted out into various grades with the help of sifters. As I've already told you, sifters are the big channis, like you have small channis at home for sifting your flour, with different size of meshes, that is jali. After sorting, they are given the brand names denoting the size of the leaves, like peok, broken orange, dust, etc. The above 5 operations of processing are part of the orthodox method, that is the old method. Lately, CTC method, that is crushing, tearing and curling method, has been adopted, which consists of Again rewinding, crushing, tearing and curling process, all done using one machine. Now next is blending. That is mixing of two or more different origin tea leaves to take the best quality tea with a well-balanced flavor. The plant is greatly affected by the type of climate it is grown. Thus, by blending, that is by mixing, the tea planter prepares his own brand to supply his customers on the basis of its flavor, color, and texture. Each brand will have its own characteristic flavor and blend in a closely guarded secret. Now, next step is packing. The tea, as we see in the market, needs a lot of care while packing to protect its flavor. Thus, generally, plywood cases with the lining of aluminium foil papers is used to keep the tea fresh and retain its flavor. Like children, you are wrapping your chapatis in aluminium foil so that they remain fresh. Like that only, the tea leaves are packed in the plywood cases with the lining of aluminium foil papers to keep the tea fresh and retain its flavor. After packing, the tea chests are marked and sent to the nearest port for export. Ready-made tea packs, tea bags and iced tea have recently come in as the latest products in the market. Now let us read the problems of pre-plantation. Many tea gardens have been closed in recent years due to various causes such as decline, that is fall in tea prices, less production of tea due to power problem, that is mainly the shortage of power, labor problems, that is the shortage of labor or the strikes by the labor, finance crisis, that is the problem related to money, labor demand, that is the demands of the labor results in the reduction in the number of laborers. Sick industry, that is old industry. A considerable number of tea gardens have gone sick, that is they have become old due to lack of infrastructure, that is their buildings, modernization and efficient management. No proper storage. Pest problem, along with mosquito, bug, a disease called bacterial black spot has also affected many plantation in northeastern estates, that is the tea fields or the tea gardens. Now let us see the area states where tea is grown in India. Tea cultivation in India is highly concentrated in a few selected regions. The two main areas known for tea production in India are Northeast India and Southeast India. Northeast India includes the states of Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram and Tripura. And South India includes Odisha, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Now coming back to your book, Northeast India, Assam Hills region is the largest tea producing area in the world. The conditions are most favorable with over 250 centimeter rainfall and temperature above 20 degrees Celsius. Morning fog helps and frost never occurs. Moreover, labor is available in plenty, that is enough labor is available. Hence, hand picking is made easy. Assam produces the most popular tea, that is pungent in taste. It is strong and used for blending the milder ones, that is light ones. It produces over 40% of the tea in the country. The second major area where tea is cultivated in India is Brahmaputra Valley. On both sides of this valley, tea plantations are a common sight. With rainfall above 200 to 300 centimeters, that is heavy rainfall, and high temperature with high humidity, that is amount of water vapor present in the air, the area provides ideal condition for tea cultivation. The cropping is done from April to December, that is The seeds are sown from April to December. This tea is in great demand all over the world and is used for blending, that is mixing, because of its strong flavor and color. Next is West Bengal. West Bengal is the second largest producer. The entire tea of West Bengal is grown in three northern districts of Darjeeling, Jalpaiguri and Cooch Behar. Here, the tree is grown on Himalayan slopes. Soils are red loams and sandy loams, and annual rainfall varies from 300 to 500 centimeter. Darjeeling tea is famous for its typical flavor. Most popular brand being Green Lipton, inferior qualities blended with Assam tea for flavor and liquor. Tea is also grown in Himachal Pradesh, Tripura, Manipur and Arunachal Pradesh, as I've shown you through a map. So children, in this picture, you can see the fine plucking method of tea, in which the women are plucking the soft tender leaves of the tea and they are putting them into the baskets tied at their back. Now, coming to South India. In South India, tea is produced in Nilgiri Hills, Cardamom, Palani and Annamalai Hills in Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. Extending from 9 degree north to 14 degree north latitudes. Tea gardens are located mostly between 300 to 1800 meter altitude, as the trees are grown along the hill slopes so that the water do not stagnate, that is standing at a place, as it may be harmful for the production of tea. The temperatures are always high and rainfall exceeds 400 centimeters, as tea crop needs a very heavy rainfall. There is never any fear of frost and conditions are ideal. In South, the places are located near the sea coast, so the temperature remains moderate throughout the year and thus there is no fear of frost like North India. Hence, productivity is higher though quality is inferior, that is low. Most of the regions get rain from both monsoons and rainfall is well distributed. Soils are mostly red, yellow and latite in origin. The cropping season is on throughout the year, that is the tea plants are grown throughout the year in India, but the best lot is produced during December and January. Nilgiri tea is famous for its fine taste and flavor. Now, importance of tea in India. India is the largest producer of tea in the world. Since it is a labor-intensive industry, that is, a lot of labor is employed in the tea factories to process the tea. It provides employment to over a million workers. In this industry, both the men and women are employed, as women are temporarily suited to the job and men take care of loading, unloading, packaging, etc. It earns a lot of foreign exchange for the country. That is, India earns a lot of money by exporting tea. So children, at the end, I hope that through both the parts of the tea, you have learned about what type of crop is tea, the origin of tea crops, types or varieties of tea, soils that are ideal for the growth of tea crop, climatic requirements, that is temperature and rainfall needed to grow tea, method of cultivation for tea crop under the headings sowing, that is transplantation and clone planting, harvesting, that is plucking of tea leaves, to go through the five operations involved in the processing of black tea, which is common drink in every home of our country, that is withering, rolling, fermentation, drying or fixing, sorting, then blending and packing, problems of tea plantation, and the area states where tea is processed in India in detail, the importance of tea in India. Thank you.